Here's a page that I recently started following on Instagram. His name is Kevin Concepts. I recently discovered him on the Explorer page on Instagram. When I saw it, I was amazed on how creative and cool his stuff is. It's really aesthetically pleasing as well. I was scrolling up and down, he's done wallets, carpets, lamps, shoes of course, all types of things. One thing that really stuck out to me though were these customs on some Chuck 70s. He did them on a gray pair though. What he simply did was got the thunderbolts from a Revenge Storm and sewed it onto the side of a Chuck 70. Super clean, super amazing in my opinion. I'm a fan of Vans, these aren't Vans, but I'm a fan of Vans, Chucks. So as soon as I saw that custom on his page, I had to hit him up. I told him how dope his work was and I asked him for permission to see if he was cool with me doing this custom on my page. He was totally game for it. So that's what I'm gonna be doing today, you guys. I'm gonna be doing those Chuck 70s with the Revenge Storm custom inspired by Kevin Concepts. Lately, you guys, I've been giving away a lot of my customs over the last couple of months. I gave away almost 8 pairs of shoes on Rejuvenator Day. I gave away the Dior Air Force Ones, the Kobe custom. That's a lot in the last couple of months. So now it's my turn. I went ahead and ordered these customs in my size so they could be just for me. The funnest thing about this process is two things. I'm still fairly new to the sewing machine, so just doing anything with the sewing machine excites me. And number two is the laser engraver. We haven't used that on a custom yet. This is gonna be the first project we do so on. Got some ideas for the circle patches that's gonna go on the inside of the shoe. All we gotta do now is head over to Doug's.
Yeah, I mean, this afternoon Vic popped into my office with this idea and I usually don't get to be involved in Vic's customs. So for me, it was a little bit of a rush, so we threw together the graphic really fast. And he brought me sort of just a crude sketch and we were able to take it into Adobe Illustrator and create our own version of that lightning bolt. So we just kind of moved things around as much as we could. And even with the lightning bolts on the storms, you know, like even when we traced it from the Revenge Storm, it just felt a little bit like wonky and awkward because you're taking a photograph of a shoe and trying to recreate a design panel. So we played with that and adjusted everything.
We had to play around with a couple different designs, but this is ultimately the one I really, really loved. Once we got a design, we went over to the laser cutter and designed it and pretty much laid it down to get it fully cut out. It took us a few tries to get it perfectly. As you can see right here, it's a little blurry, you know, not perfect. This was our second attempt. A little bit better, but again, not crispy at all. The All-Star was not sharp at all.
Yeah, so troubleshooting was like really getting the cut. So we had never actually cut a piece of leather with the laser engraver. So not only did it engrave the graphic pieces of this, but it actually cut out all the way around. And so getting the right like pressure and settings to get that cut to go all the way through the leather was a little bit of a process. And then really trying to work with the depth of the engraving on the graphic. It took us a couple tries just to get it just right. Without overburning it or just really making too deep of an impression on that leather.
We also went ahead and added little tiny holes all around the sides. That'll help me as a guide to when I go in and sew this patch, it can look as crispy and professional as possible. This right here is a perfect patch. Clean leather, perfect even engraving all around the patch. Got the 2020 nice and crispy, the Vic Almighty logo, All-Star, Stormy Weather, all nice and sharp. Same thing with the little guided holes all around. That'll help me for the sewing process as a guided hole so I could get it as crispy and professional as possible. This step is gonna be super fun. Again, I've been super excited using my sewing machine. What we're gonna do first is simply glue it onto the shoe first, and then with some white thread, we're gonna sew it onto the shoe. Forgot the thread. All right, guys, we made it to Joann's. This is where I buy my thread. Joann's, ignore my window. We're going through monsoon season here in Arizona, so it's not smart to wash your car. Let's go get some thread. Yo, I'm hungry. I don't know what to get for lunch today. Hi. All right, guys, so my good friend Jim recommended me this thread that he uses on his customs and that I used on my Naker 5 Jordan 5s and I'm gonna use on this custom as well. Oops. So I'm actually grabbing a few different color threads. There's other projects I need to work on. I do need some more off-white and white thread though for this project that we're working on. White and some dirty off-white. Let's get both just to see which one I like more. Time to go. All right, we got our thread. We just got out of Joann's. We got a few different colors. This is the stuff that my good friend Jim recommended me. It's Gutterman's thread from Joann's. We use these on the Dior Air Force Ones. I use them on the Laker Jordan 5s. It's a perfect size. There's different colors. Highly recommended. Now it's time for lunch. Usually, I go to get salmon teriyaki bowls from AJ's, but it's a little bit too late for that now, so we're probably gonna go with Chipotle. Pretty much what I'm gonna do next before I start threading the machine, we're gonna grab our double-sided tape for fabric, simply lay down some on the swoosh. I don't know why I keep on calling it a swoosh. It's not a swoosh, it's a thunderbolt. I think this is perfect. We're ready to keep it going. We got our thread, now it's time to thread our machine. If you guys want me to do a whole video on how to use a machine like this, let me know. So far, so good, you guys. We got the first light down. I'm gonna throw it on time now so I can just do this whole thing all in one shot. That's gonna be it, you guys. These Chuck 70s are complete, and honestly, I am super happy on how these turned out. This project was super exciting for me for several reasons. For one, we use my sewing machine. Anything with the sewing machine excites me. Second, we use our laser machine. We've never used that on camera before, never used it on leather for any of my projects. So to be able to do the Thunderbolts on both shoes and this custom laser engraved patch was super phenomenal. Also, the most exciting thing about all of this though is that these are in my size. I did both shoes. These are going straight to feet, you guys. I do want to give a quick shout out to Kevin Concepts for coming out with this sick design. Thank you so much for letting me use your design on my shoes, man. So cool, you guys. I don't know about you, but I'm ready to put these on my feet.